In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Welcome to St. Paul's Servant Prep class. Today's lecture 6 about service. We're going to talk about the role of the Holy Spirit in the servant life. So let's get started. Service, part 6 of 6. The Holy Spirit and the servant. The objectives: to discuss the many different roles of the Holy Spirit in the life of the servant, and to show the relationship of success, to know how to kindle the Holy Spirit in the service. The role of the Holy Spirit in the servant life: prepare the servant, send the servant, guide the servant, entice the servant, and prepare the audience. First, we'll start by preparation of the servant. The Holy Spirit entices the youth to be an active in their spiritual life. Among the many youths, the Holy Spirit will work in some of them to get them more engaged in spiritual activity, more engaged in attending tasbihah, midnight praises, prayer by Agbaya, attend liturgy early, visit others, attend the spiritual meeting more oftenly, start to focus on their Bible reading, be more active in confession, be more active in spiritual activity within the church. The Holy Spirit encourages the servant to acquire a pure heart and help him to get rid of the bad qualities like envy, jealousy, hatred, discrimination, and so on. So in conclusion, the Holy Spirit leads the servant to behave in a role model to the others. The Holy Spirit encourages the servant to spend more time in spiritual means, arrive early to service, do their daily reading, a good attendance in the meeting, disregard unnecessary social gathering, join spiritual activity like choir, like hymns, participate in the tasbihah. Here I have to quote what St. Paul mentioned in his first epistle to the Corinthians, chapter 14. What's the conclusion then? I will pray with the Spirit. I will also pray with understanding. I will sing with the Spirit. I will also sing with understanding. The Holy Spirit has the servant actively participate in the preparation class, joining servant prep class, encourage them to attend regularly and keep their absence to minimum, be active participant in project, in quizzes, in daily verses and daily messages, to be an active member in the servant prep course. The Holy Spirit makes the servant dedicate certain time for their own service. Help him to complete the service with effort. Make the servant willing to offer sacrifice in his service. Sacrifice including time, including effort. Help him to prepare the lesson under talk. Help him to check on the absentee and visit the sick. Help him to read the prayer and prepare to make the changes in the schedule if necessary. The Holy Spirit also gives the servant a better and clear understanding of their role as a servant. As a servant, they should gather and not scatter. The servant should always be more inclusive and not exclusive. Try to gather people around him. Don't try to exclude anyone. In the contrary, look for those who have been ignored and neglected by the others. Here we have to keep a heed to an important warning. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption, Ephesians 4:30. The servant who spend their week on their entertainment and only remember they have a service and they're gonna start work on it in the last minute, those are the type of servant who grieve the Holy Spirit. So we talked first about the role of the Holy Spirit to prepare the servant. Now about sending the servant. The Holy Spirit selects certain people to be sent for service. The Holy Spirit select the candidate to the servant prep class and help him. The same way we have seen in the story of Barnabas and Saul, when the Holy Spirit said, "Separate to me apart Paul and Barnabas for the work I called them to do." The Holy Spirit also will judge the servant. And we have a clear story here from the book of Acts, chapter 5, Ananias and Sapphira. When Peter said to him, then said to her later on, "How is that you have agreed together to test the spirit of the Lord? Look, The feet of those who have buried your husband are at the door, and they will carry you. You have not lied to me, but you lied to the Holy Spirit. So the Holy Spirit prepare the servant, send the servant, and judge the servant. The Holy Spirit also guides the servant. Every servant needs to know what are the guidelines to assess the success of his service. The Holy Spirit will help you to know exactly what's your strength and what's your weakness, and help you to address the weakness and try to rectify the weak point in your service in a good manner. The Holy Spirit will help the student and also will help the servant, both of them. The Holy Spirit will entice the servant for growth in the grace and knowledge in their own. The servant who is filled by the Holy Spirit will always grow in grace and knowledge in his own or her own. Be willing all the time to talk about Christ, about the church, about the saint, about the Bible. The Holy Spirit encourage you on your own to listen to more sermon, to read more homilies, to attend more social and spiritual meeting, to be more actively involved in other service outside the church. So the Holy Spirit will keep you going and going in the grace and knowledge. At any moment, I call you to cover one class that's not your class, you'll be ready to do that. Why? Because you are filled with the Spirit. At any moment, we ask you to give a talk to a certain group of people or to give us a spiritual meditation, you are ready to do that. Why? Because you are filled with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit encourages you in your own time outside Sunday school to grow in the knowledge, to keep reading, to keep exploring, to keep growing in your own. The Holy Spirit also prepares the audience. So it's not just relation between the Holy Spirit and servant, but also the audience. The servant always pray before the start of the service. Pray that God open the ears of the audience to listen and pay attention to what he's going to say. He also prays that the Holy Spirit open the heart of the audience. They can understand, embrace, acknowledge, and make their heart repenting and relenting and willing to act according to the servant talk. The Holy Spirit also make the servant remember those who didn't attend, the absentee, and think about them and pray for them. The Holy Spirit work in the heart of the audience to make him pay attention to the speaker. So the next object is we want to know how to kindle the Holy Spirit in the service. How to kindle the Holy Spirit? By praying several times each day. Prayer means connecting with the Holy Spirit. You cannot say you are connected to God and you don't talk to him. So keep praying to him will lead to kindling of the Holy Spirit. By reading the Bible daily and meditating his verse in the stories, in the saint life. By limiting your time on worldly fun. Limit the time that you spend in earthly fun, in watching game, in watching movies, in going outside with your friend. The more time you spend in holy activity, the better a chance the Holy Spirit will work in you. The less time you dedicate to earthly activity, the better for your spiritual growth. Pray for the dwelling of the Holy Spirit in you. Pray for the coordinator in the service and their service. Read the Bible and succession each day. These are the important way to keep the Holy Spirit kindled in your heart. These are the objectives we cover today. Finally, I leave you with memorization verses. What is the conclusion then? I will pray with the Spirit. I will also pray with understanding. I will sing with the Spirit. I will also sing with understanding. 1 Corinthians 14:15. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God. Ephesians 4:30. Be fervent in the Spirit, serving the Lord. Romans 12:11. Thank you so much for your attention, and I see you next week. And glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.